tumekutana hapa leo viongozi ambao wamechaguliwa kutoka mirengo mbalimbali, lakini leo tumekutana kama viongozi wa jamii kutoka mkoa wa Magharibi kujadili masuala ambayo yanahusu jamii yetu na masuala mengine ambayo ni ipuka ambayo imekuwa inatendeka katika taifa la Kenya, kutathmini kamilifu nafasi yetu katika hii serikali na katika taifa la Kenya iko ipi. Na pia tumeona sisi kama viongozi wa sasa kwamba kuna pengo la uongozi katika upande ule wa Magharibi. Kuna wale viongozi ambao wamekwekwa kwa kule mbele, lakini tunaona kwamba masuala ya jamii hawayaangalii kikamilifu. Na ndiposa tumejitokeza sisi kama viongozi ambao tuko sasa tuanze ule mjadala, alafu tukitoka hapa kuna mipango mingine ambayo tumepanga ili huu mjadala uendelee na watu pia waendelee kuhisi kwamba wao katika taifa la Kenya na pia katika nafasi katika serikali. Hatuwezi kuwa tunaunda chama kipya, ni mchakato. Na unajua kama viongozi mnakutana kupata lunch tu, wakati mwingine kuna mama ambaye inaleta pamoja. Sio lazima iwe tu kwamba ni kuunda chama. Kama ni vyama viko vingi sana. Kwa sasa swala ambalo ni la muhimu sana na la urgent sana sio mambo ya vyama, bali ni hatima yetu sisi kama jamii. Tawe sio ya Magharibi peke yake. Tawe ni ile mambo tu ambayo ina challenge status quo. Bila mambo yapo tunakubaliana, bila yapo ambapo tunaona kwamba inaweza kufanyika katika njia nyingine. Lakini leo haikuwa mambo ya tawe. Leo ilikuwa ni viongozi ambao tuko sasa kukaa chini na kujadili. Hatujakaa tukaongea kama viongozi kutoka sehemu ya Magharibi. Wengine kama Sifuna amechaguliwa hapa Nairobi, lakini pia ni wapande ile nyingine. So tukasema tukae chini na tuongee.
Hatujaangalia chama, tumesema tukutane kama viongozi, the new generation leaders, tufanye analysis na pia postmortem, kwa sababu kuna emerging political alignments, na tukasema tuone ile interest ya jamii yetu iko wapi. Sababu tumefanya hivyo ni kwa sababu wale viongozi ambao wamekuwa tunaona hawajatuelekeza vizuri. Hiyo ndio ukweli wa maneno, na tukasema kwamba tukuje sisi kama viongozi wa the new generation tuanze kusemezana, na tumekubaliana kwa kauli moja kwamba hatuwezi jiongelea vile sisi tunataka. Ile shida ambayo tumekuwa nayo ni kwamba wale viongozi ambao wamekuwa hapa juu wamekuwa kiongea mambo yao kibinafsi, alafu wanasema wana represent community. Si tumesema kabla tu decide kitu chochote leo lazima turudi kwa watu wetu, tusikie wananchi na watu wa mkoa wa Magharibi wanataka nini. So tumekubaliana kwamba tunaenda kuwa na mkutano wa viongozi grassroots leaders wa mkoa wa Magharibi yote, kaunti zetu tano zote, on Monday kule Kakamega, na tunaenda kuleta viongozi wote wakuje tusemezane, tuambiane what is our way forward as a community, na tungependa tutembee aje, tungependa tuongee na nani, we want now to chart our way forward as the new generation leaders from the western region.
And as I said, as they have said, we have very many challenges in this country, and one of the things that I hold very clearly in my head is that as leaders you cannot just sit and do nothing when there are challenges that are facing the people. I think it is incumbent upon us to come together, to reason together and try to see how we can be able to provide solutions to some of the problems we have. As you know, even the governor and these members will tell you, Western has also seen a lot of the Gen Z protests, and they are raising critical issues that need to be addressed. And it is our hope and desire that out of this consultation and the meeting that has been proposed in Kakamega, we can all agree on what it is that we need to do as leaders living in this time right now when the leadership is upon us, to be able to provide some solutions to the people of Kenya. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. You said the people who are in government right now from the Western region have failed you.
I think there is a common indictment on everybody in leadership right now. I don't think it is just the people from Western. I think there is an acknowledgement across the board that we wouldn't have gotten where we are if there was leadership in the country. And that realization is what brings all these people together amongst us here, and many more who will join. I believe we can put our heads together. Honorable Mugabe, Honorable Nabi, all these people have Milanya, they have people who are, have the capacity to be able to proffer some solutions to some of the issues. So we are not interested in attacking anyone. We just want to consult amongst ourselves and see if it is possible for us to proffer some solutions to the problems facing the country.
Okay, before before I give it to the rest.
All policy local. We are starting from the local, coming to the nation. But watch this space.
Thank you.
Yes.
Watch. Watch. I'm going to the airport.
Oh.
We are ready when you are ready. I think the rest will share clips. So I want to introduce the members of this delegation. My name is Caleb Amisi. I'm a member of parliament representing Saboti constituency on ODM party and deputy organizing secretary of ODM party. Here we have member for Lugari, Honorable Nabin Nabuera, and the county secretary of ODM, Kakamega County. And we have our professor here, Wilberforce Oundo, representing Busia from the Funyula constituency. We have Mugabe from Likuyani constituency. They will have a moment to speak, but I want first of all to read the statement for this presser, and we'll open up for questions. So we have met here this morning as elected MPs, among the ones who have before us. In addition, we have Honorable Kibangendi, who is supposed to be here, Honorable Sothi, who is supposed to be here, Honorable Edwin Sifuna is supposed to be here, and they are a part of this statement that have all signed. And we've met here as elected MPs and members in good standing of the Orange Democratic Movement party to set the record straight with regard to recent happenings within the party. We wish to make clear that many of us, if not all of us here, were present during both the ODM and the Azimio parliamentary group held on the 12th of July at the Jaramogi Foundation in Nairobi. At no time during the said meetings was it resolved that either the party or the coalition will be joining a coalition with William Ruto's KK party. It therefore came as a shock when senior members of ODM showed up on a list of cabinet appointees announced by Ruto yesterday. That some of our leaders have chosen to join a government indicted by the Kenyan people reflects badly on a party that has always advocated for and stood with the people. We have all along maintained support for the ongoing struggle to address the long-standing governance issues bedeviling Kenya, and are appalled that we are now seen to be joining forces with the people responsible for these issues. To make it worse, the appointment do not reflect the diversity of the party we love, as there clearly was no regard to gender, age, or regional considerations. We wish to reiterate that the position of the party, as communicated by our Secretary General, who is Edwin Sifuna, earlier this week, that indeed the decision by our four comrades were personal and not as a result of any decision passed by the party. We call on the party leadership to move with speed and replace them. That is the end of the statement. I want to finish by saying that ODM party is like an army. Four of our generals and the brigadiers have deserted duty and they've gone to sleep with our enemy. It has no direction from the commander-in-chief, who is Raila Amolo Odinga. The party leader was abroad on a private visit, only to come back and find four generals and a brigadier have deserted duty and joined the opposite camp. So we are saying this is not the position of the party. Such monumental decision affecting the history, the principles, the ideologies of the party must have been passed by the parliamentary group meeting. I want to give my colleagues to add on what I've said, and I'll leave room for questions.